Because oftentimes parents and their kids really never get the chance to talk about sex, and experts say the big reason for that is because many teens and even some of their parents say it can be really uncomfortable to talk about that issue.
Yeah, I remember the talks when you were younger, little.
I didn't have one.
Uncomfortable, I think, is a good way to describe it. Well, that's why today Logan High School hosted a nationally known speaker who's hoping to make that communication easier. News Channel 8's Bart Winkler has the story.
A lot of us are kind of afraid that if we say anything, they're going to somehow, like, make it into an argument, or they're just going to harp on us.
There are many reasons why teenagers choose not to talk about sex with their parents, and why parents are uncomfortable talking to their kids about it as well. Mike Domish is hoping to change that.
We take sort of the cover off the issue and make it more easy to talk about and say, yeah, everybody's dealing with this. Let's be open, let's be honest, and let's give parents some really easy ways to open up these conversations.
By opening up that communication, Domish hopes students will understand how to deal with sex and intimacy.
We show students a very simple, easy way to have respectful relationships, respectful intimacy situations, so that their boundaries are always respected.
To talk to your partner, not just like, think they assume they know something or they don't know something.
I've learned a lot about respecting your own limits and that you really don't have to do anything until you're ready to.
And by establishing these relationships, Domish hopes sex is something parents and kids won't have problems talking about.
A lot of parents dread, sort of fear, these conversations about intimacy and dating when it comes to the teenagers. We're going to teach them how to make it fun so the teenagers actually want to engage with them.
In La Crosse, Bart Winkler, News Channel 8.
Now, in response, some students at Logan are starting a group designed to discuss these issues all year long.
And they're still working out the details, but they do hope that they'll be able to talk to kids at the middle schools later this year.
Mike Domish was brought to Logan through Gunderson Lutheran Sexual Abuse Counseling and Support Program.
Yeah, so earlier tonight I was able to sit down with Mike to talk more about this issue. Mike, thanks for being with us tonight.
Thank you for having me.
Busy day. What kind of reaction did you get today at Logan High School from the students?
We had a great reaction from the students. Very energetic, very enthusiastic. A lot of students coming up and actually thanking us, saying, you know, we really appreciate you coming here. Thanks for saying this. Our fellow students needed to hear this, both from men and women. In fact, we had one young man that came back out at 5:45 because he knew I was speaking at 6:30 to sit down and just have some time to talk and share and ask questions. So just really overall wonderfully positive feedback.
Now, that was during the day. Now, tonight, you got a chance to address a lot of the parents over at Logan High School. What kind of questions were they asking you? Did they get a chance to ask some questions?
They did. It's a very open forum that we had tonight so that they could ask questions, sort of look into the issue a little more deeply. And really what we look at is their biggest fears, their biggest concerns, you know, which are my child becoming too sexually active or my child being sexually assaulted or raped on a date, those major concerns, and how we can help parents address those issues.
All right. Now, your organization is called the Date Safe Project, and you really have a very personal reason why you felt this message needs to get out there. Now, why is it? What happened?
Yeah, what happened was I was in college at the time and I received a phone call that the youngest of my sisters had been raped back here in Wisconsin, and it just devastated me. I couldn't believe what I was hearing, and watching my family go through that pain, my sister go through that pain. Soon later, I had to look in the mirror and go, well, this is a guy, how do I date? And as I looked in the mirror, I realized, you know, I never asked. I just assume what the person wants. Isn't that what everybody does? Started talking to friends. He said, well, yeah, that's what everybody does. And I realized, wow, we have a setup here for trouble. One person just makes their move until the other one stops them. It's a form of self-defense. It's not a choice, really. And so that made me reevaluate as a man how we make these choices and what's the best way to really give a person a choice. That's to ask.
So ask first is one of the most basic messages. Okay, also, what kind of, it's almost like a cultural change that needs to happen. Do you think it's something that as you talk to kids, does it make sense to them, or do you think the guys are taking the message one way and girls take the message a different way?
Yeah, it's one of the most common questions I get. People go, well, what are the odds they're going to really use this? You know, if you went up to a teenager and said, hey, you got to ask before you kiss someone, they're going to laugh their heads off at you. They will. So what we do is we come in and we show in the program, we role play asking scenes so they get to see positive examples of asking. And what teenagers say when you ask them, you say, all right, so you don't ask, you just go for it. Is it awkward? Yes, they admit that. Is it weird? Yes. Are you afraid of rejection? Yes. So help me out again. Why don't you ask? And they're like, well, because we don't know how. So then we teach them how. And they're like, wow, that's not that difficult, saying, may I kiss you to somebody? And then teach them how to handle it. If they say no, they realize, you know what, this is easier. And so now they're walking out going, thanks. Guys say, thanks for making this easier. Women say, yeah, you know what? I don't have to be submissive and wait all the time. I can take control. So it empowers people.
Very good. And Mike Domish, thanks so much for being with us tonight as well.
Oh, thank you, Martha.
So hopefully it'll be easier for kids and parents to talk about that. And if you'd like more information about Mike or his organization, you can always go to their website at www.datesafeproject.org.
What a great idea. I'm surprised somebody didn't think of this before.
I know, and he's so open about it, too, which I think makes it really approachable for kids.
Helps everybody out all the way around.
Yeah.